Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Dore. The topic covered is join relation left outer join. In previous video, we considered the types of join and different join condition. In this video, we are going to cover the topic left outer join, a type of outer join. The outer join operation compute the join and then add the tuples from one relation that does not match tuples in the another relation to the result of the join. This outer join operation is used to avoid the loss of the information. Learning outcome: at the end of the session, students will be able to write the queries using left outer join operation for given relations. As we know that there are following join types and the join conditions as shown in the table. These three join conditions, natural, on and using, are used with all these join types, that is inner join, left outer join, right outer join and the full outer join. Consider outer join. The outer join operation is an extension of the join operation to deal with the missing information. It computes the join and then adds the tuples from one relation that does not match the tuple in the other relation to the result of the join. The outer join operation works in a manner similar to the natural join operation but preserves those tuples that would be lost in and join by creating the tuples in the result containing null values. There are actually three forms of the operation: left outer join, right outer join and full outer join. All three forms of the outer join compute the join and add extra tuples to the result of the join. Now consider left outer join. Left outer join type returns all the rows from the left hand side relation specified in the condition and only those rows from the other table where the join fields are equal. The left outer join would return the all records from the table 1 and only those records from the table 2 that intersect with the table 1. The left outer join takes all the tuples in the left relation that did not match with any tuple in the right relation, pairs the tuple with the null values for all other attributes from the right hand side relation and add them to the result of the natural join. All the information from the left hand side relation is present in the result of the left outer join. We compute the left outer join operation as follows. First, compute the result of the inner join. Then, for every tuple t in the left hand side relation that does not match any tuple in the right hand side relation in the inner join, add a tuple r to the result of the join constructed as follows. The attributes of the r that are derived from the left hand side relation are filled in with the values from the tuple t. The remaining attribute of the r are filled with the null values. Consider the relation for the queries on the left outer join. Relation loan with the attribute loan number, branch name and the amount. Relation borrower with the attribute customer name and the loan number. In both relation, common attribute is loan number and here borrower information is missing for L260 in the borrower relation and loan information is missing for L155 in the loan relation. Consider the left outer join using the natural join condition. The meaning of the join condition natural in terms of which tuples from the two relation match is straightforward. The ordering of the attribute in the result of the natural join is as follows. The join attribute, that is the attribute common to both relation, appear first in the order in which they appear in the left hand side relation. Then next come all the non-join attribute of the left hand side relation and finally all non-joined attributes of the right-hand side relation. Relation loan and borrower. The query select star from loan natural left outer join borrower. The left outer join preserves tuple only in the relation name before the left outer join operation. In the result, the tuple for L260 includes the null for the attribute that appear only in the schema of the borrower relation, that is customer name. Consider the left outer join using on join condition. The on condition allows a general predicate over the relation being joined. Loan and the borrower relation. Query is select star from the loan left outer join borrower on loan.loanNumber is equal to borrower.loanNumber. On and where behaves differently for the outer join. The reason for this is that outer join adds null padded tuples only for those tuples that do not contribute to the result of the corresponding inner join. The on condition is a part of the outer join specification, but a where clause is not. Here in the result, the common attribute loan number appear twice and the tuple for L260 includes null for attribute that appear only in the schema of the borrower relation, that is customer name and the loan number. Left outer join using join condition. The using clause is a form of natural join that only requires the values to match on the specified attributes. The relation loan and borrower. Query for this left outer join using the using condition is select star from loan left outer join borrower using loan number. The result of this query is shown on this slide. Here, the common attribute loan number appears only once. Till now, we consider the left outer join using join condition natural, on and using. Now, pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, write the queries for left outer join using natural, on and using condition along with the result. The employee relation with the attribute, employee name, street and the city, and the employee salary relation with the employee name, branch name and the salary. The employee salary relation with the employee name, branch name and the salary. So it is given on the slide. Here, the salary information is missing for the employee Smith in the employee salary relation, and the employee information is missing for the employee get in the employee relation. I hope all of you have completed this activity. Consider the following relation employee and the employee salary. First, consider the left outer join using the natural condition. The query is select star from EMP natural left outer join EMP salary. The result is shown in the table. In the result, the common attribute employee name appear only once, and the tuple for Smith includes the null value for the attribute that appear only in the schema of the employee salary relation, that is branch name and the salary. Now consider the left outer join using on condition for the following relations. The query is select star from EMP left outer join EMP salary on EMP dot employee name equals to EMP salary dot employee name. The result is shown on the slide, which contains the common attribute employee name twice. Now consider the left outer join using using condition for the following relation. The query is select star from the EMP left outer join EMP salary using employee name. The result contains the common attribute employee name only once. Here on this slide, queries for left outer join using natural, on and using conditions along with the results are given. The results using join condition, natural and using are same, in which the common attribute employee name appear only once. In join condition on, the common attribute employee name appears twice. These are the references used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.